Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Mr. Lee Physics class. So today, we are going to direct current. So this new chapter is related to direct current. Introduction. So let's look at the circuit, the electric circuit. The electric circuit consists of some of the some component of electric device. So there are capacitor, resistor, diode, and also the, okay, and so on. So now, let's move to the next slide. Ladies and gentlemen, the objective lessons for today are the first objective one, define EMF and potential difference. Objective two, understand electric energy from the definitions of EMF and potential difference. Objective three, use the formula of power equal to IE. And know that objective four, know that the source of EMF have internal resistance and use the equation where the EMF minus IR equal to V. So the capital V will be the potential difference. And next, finally, understand the effect of internal resistance of the power supply to the load. Ladies and gentlemen, now observe the diagram. A dry cell is connected to a bulb. So the diagram on the right side show that illusion of the circuit of the dry cell, the dry cell in the circuit, and also the bulb. The bulb represented by a generator, where a dry cell is represented by a pump. When the electricity is generated, the current is flowed through the circuit. So once the electron, let's say the electron flow from the terminal negative to the terminal positive, which pass through the bulb light up. Same. That is the water pump. The pump pumps the water to move the generator. That means that the dry cell actually is working. The illusion that represents the battery or dry cell is the pump. The water pump is working, pumping the water. Once the water moves, the generator moves. Same situation when the electron is moving and forced to move by the battery, so the current produced. Analogy between the electric flow and the water flow. Battery and pump. The pump drives water around the system, and the cell drive charge around the circuit. The pump create a pressure difference from the water to flow, but the cell create a potential difference for the charge to flow. But how about the bulb and the turbine generator? The turbine and the generator converts the kinetic energy of the water to electrical energy. The bulb convert electrical energy to heat and light. The water and the charge means that they are the quantities which flow around the system or the circuit. Water and charge are conserved by each system, and they are recycled. So this means that the charge and the water, okay, are recycled, used and recycled flow in the circuit. So from here, what is meant by EMF? EMF is the electromotive force. Let's look at the structure of the dry cell. Inside are carbon electrode and the electrolyte. Electrolyte means that chemical. So the dry cell consists of chemical and is connected through a resistor. Once the switch is off or the switch is on, when the circuit is connected, so there are something moving. From positive terminal to negative terminal, there are positive charge or most known as the current. So current flow from the positive terminal to the negative terminal through the resistor. When the current flow through the resistor, the heat is generated and the heat dissipated through the resistor. So we can set that the EMF, the meaning of the EMF of a source is the potential difference across its terminal when no current is drawn from the source. A cell is said to have an EMF of 1 watt when it supplies 1 joule of energy to 1 coulomb of charge passing through it. So ladies and gentlemen, we can set that the what is the difference between the EMF and potential difference? Potential difference is the energy needed, the work done needed to move 1 column of charge from one point to another point. That means from one, we can set that they are the work needed to move 1 column of charge from one terminal of electric device to another electric device. EMF is the potential difference across its terminal. That means that this one, okay, you see, when no current is drawn from the source, that means that we directly make sure the potential difference across the terminal positive and terminal negative of the dry cell. So this means that this is the concept, the potential difference and the EMF. Potential difference will be the voltage. The potential difference will be the voltage across any electronic device. But the EMF is the voltage of the battery, the voltage of the source. Mostly the EMF used in the source that produces the electricity by using the chemical reaction. For example, battery or dry cell. So from here, we can set that. Okay, so 1 watt, as we know that 1 watt is equal to 1 joule per coulomb. Okay. So now let's go to the next slide. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let's look at this slide. If we have certain some of the, what is that, the circuit. Let's say now, if the switch is not connected, and the voltage. If the voltage measure the by the wattmeter. Second test that. And five. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 circuit. Which one make sure the potential difference? Which one make sure the EMF? If just now, as teacher, as I mentioned before, if we just make sure the potential, if you just make sure the voltage, which the voltage is make sure just only the battery. So that means that in case number five, the voltmeter just measure the battery. So this is EMF. Okay. So that means that this voltmeter make sure the reading of the EMF. Okay. So now the let's look at the circuit number one. This one, is it current flow through the bulb or resistor? No, no current flow. That means that this current just flow through the voltmeter and the battery only, right? Is it same situation with number five? Yes, so this one make sure EMF, okay? Now, this case, the current is flowing through the bulb. And at the moment, we are measuring the potential. Okay, it is measuring the voltage. At this time, this voltage in this circuit, the voltmeter is measure potential difference, but not EMF. Okay, because it's measure the, okay, some current is flowing. If the current now, current still flow through the bulb, so the voltmeter measure potential difference. Okay, if half, no matter how, actually now the current still flow through the bulb, right? There is a bulb flow through and the voltmeter is parallel to the bulb or parallel to the battery, so this still measure the potential difference. EMF is measure only when there is none of the current flow through any electric device. The current just flow through the voltmeter and the source to produce the electric only. So this are the difference between the potential difference and the electromotive force. Let's go back to our slide. So, okay, still loading. Okay, so class, let's look at the slide. What is mean by, what is the EMF of the cell? The EMF is the energy supplied to each column of charge by the source to drive the charge around the complete around a complete circuit. EMF is equal to energy provided by the cell divided by the charge. Okay, so that means that we just need the the formula EMF is equal to the energy provided by the cell. Okay, so the calculation not important. Okay, just an example only. Okay, next we go to the next slide. Now the potential difference. Potential difference, the definition. The definition of the potential difference. Potential difference between two points is the energy required to move unit positive charge from one point to the other. This means from the left point to the other side through the bulb. One column is moved through, so the bulb is lit up. So from here, what is meant by power dissipated? The power is the energy lost by one column of charge as it passes through the resistor where it is V. Therefore, the energy E lost by column of by Q column of charge is E equal to QV. Okay. So power is the rate of change of the energy. Energy is equal to QV. Work done is equal to QV. So that means that power is dE over dt or dQ over dt. Okay. So d. Okay. As we get the final equation, we get that P power is equal to IV sin I is equal to dQ over dt. Okay, so the energy loss from one, okay, the charge when the charge moves through a resistor. So the energy loss considered is E. So normally the energy loss as heat, that means that the heat is dissipated through the resistor. Let's look at the slide. When a column of charge is moved through a battery or source, we call that is the EMF. So the energy gained by one column of charge passing through the cell is E, EMF. Therefore, the energy E gained by Q column of charge is given by E energy equal to Q. Actually, it's E equal to QV, right? Okay, the EMF actually is the same concept with the voltage, same dimension with the voltage. So the power supply is equal to the power gain. Okay, the power supplied by the cell is equal to the power gain by the charge. So this means that we get that the power supplied by the cell equal to IE. E consider is the EMF. Now, we notice that P is equal to VI or P equal to IV. So let's say we have the circuit EMF and is connected series to a resistor of 20 ohm and one another resistor of 10 ohm. The potential difference across 20 ohm is 10 watt and across the 10 ohm resistor is 5 watt. So the power dissipated by 20 ohm of resistor is 10. Let's say we find out the V equal by find out the current. Okay. So from here, if, as we know that in series circuit, current is in the circuit or current pass through the resistor of 20 ohm and 10 ohm are equal because they are in series connection. So we can use 5 over 10, we get 0.5. Or we use 10 over 20, we still get 0.5. So from here, the current flow is 0.5. Okay, how about the power dissipated? Okay, so we use 10. Okay, P equal to IV. So P equal to IV, we get that the power dissipated by 20 ohm is 5 watt. How about dissipated by 10 ohm resistor? So it is half only, that is 2.5 watt. So by using the formula of P equal to IV. Ladies and gentlemen, as a conclusion, we can set that the EMF of a source is defined as the energy supplied to each column of charge by the source to drive the charge around a complete circuit. Next, potential difference between two points in a circuit is the energy required by one column charge to move between the two points. Positive charge, yeah? One column of positive charge. Both EMF and potential difference are of unit joule per column, or easiest, we said that there is watt. Power dissipated by a resistor is equal to voltage times current. That means that P equal to IV. Power output of a cell, power is equal to EMF of the battery or of the source to produce the electric times with the current. Now, let's move to the next slide. We notice that a battery is connected to a switch and connected to a voltmeter. When the current is switched on, when the switch is on or the switch is connected, the voltmeter show reading of 1.5 watt. That means that now the voltmeter is series to the battery, which connected to a switch. So from here, the voltmeter now is measure the EMF of the battery. That means that it is 1.5 watt. Next. Sorry. Where are we now? Next, we notice that a battery is connected to a switch, then the wire is connected to a resistor. Then the resistor is back to the positive terminal. And the voltmeter is connected parallel, one point from the left side of the resistor to the positive terminal of the voltmeter, and the negative is to the right side of the resistor. So that means that when the switch is connected, current flow, and now the current just show that is 1.35 watt. Just now, the battery. Once we make sure the voltage just only for battery only, is equal to 1.5 watt. But when the battery is connected to a resistor, so it just shows 1.35 watt. This 1.35 watt is the potential difference in the circuit. The EMF is 1.5. Potential difference is equal to 1.35. Now, we look at here. If each of the battery is 1.5 watt, that means here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. X battery means that 1.5, 3, 6, 9, 12. Total is 12 watt. When we short circuit from the terminal to the negative terminal without any electronic device, we notice that nothing happened. What about? Okay, again, nothing happened. Confirm nothing happened. If I replace the battery, just now battery, X battery with 12 watt. Now, I use a single battery of 12 watt. What happened? One, the two terminal connect. So we notice that the spark produced. Okay. So why this situation happened? This situation happened is because of if there is a battery. This is a battery, yeah. The battery inside actually consists of the concept of a resistor. This we call that is the internal resistor. Now you see the battery, the resistor, and also the internal resistor. Internal resistor. Both of them are all of them are connected in series. That means that what we can set that the EMF, okay, EMF and R, small r and capital R, the current actually are equal. Okay, because they are in series connection. Now let's move to the next slide. We notice that, okay, so we notice that what will happen when the capital R increase. So now if the R is zero, this means none, this means that the reading also zero, the current is 3 ampere. If I increase, we notice that just now, if this one 1.5 watt, the voltage pass through is 1.5 watt, 3 ampere. Once I increase the reading of the capital R, this reading reduced and the current in the circuit also reduced 2.1. Okay, so notice or not, the EMF remain, but the potential difference across the big resistor and the internal resistor, so all of them reduce each other. Okay, so once I increase to 1 ohm, this means that 1 watt. So this means this left 0.5 watt. If I increase to 1.5, this means that no matter how the current, sorry, the potential difference across the resistor, the big resistor, the load, and also the resistance, internal resistance. So all of them, 1.1 plus 0.5 watt, 0.4 watt is equal to the EMF of the battery. This means that EMF considered is the total voltage in the circuit. Okay, in series, the total voltage is shared. Okay, so it's shared by the resistor, the capital R and the small r. Now, we notice that the circuit, once the R increase, okay, now what we need to do is the power across the load, power across the load, okay? P is equal to I to R. When there is none of the R, none R, no reading of the capital R, that means that 0, 1. Once I increase to 0.5, we notice that, okay, from none, okay, increase a bit, you see the, okay, you see the green color, okay, the power will increase, okay? So that means that now increase and increase. But once the R become higher, so we notice that, okay, it will be reduced, you see? Okay, so from here, from zero, actually is the power is depending on the current, I2. So once the current is higher, the current increase, okay, keep on increase. Look at the current, one, okay, current is 3 ampere. The current is reducing. One, it is, okay, what is that? The resistance increase until, okay, 1.5, that means the current is smaller. The current actually is I the power 2. So from here, you see, no matter how power is power, power is directly proportional to I2, I squared. Power also directly proportional to R. When the R increase, we look at the R. When the R increase, the power increase. Okay, but when increase higher, the power reduce. Why? The most effective is I square, because the I square, okay, the R, the resistance of the load increase will cause the current in the circuit reduce. So this means that if the circuit, the current in the circuit reduce, that means that it also can reduce the power in the circuit, you see? Okay. Now, we go to the next slide. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the Zoom, okay, this Zoom will stop in less than 1 minute. If stop, then you must reconnect the Zoom, yeah? Okay, now we look at the power. Power, V is equal to IR. By using the V,